Did you say chocolate?
Every now and again, the need for something extremely sweet wins the war an individual's taste buds are having with their brain. And the need for the ever-sweet intervention of candy is needed. Whether it is in chocolate form or in the hundreds of fruity candy options, there's plenty to choose from to make your mouth perform somersaults in your head. Here are 10 sweet facts about your favorite candy.
What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
An amazing amount of M&Ms are produced year-round.
Interesting. Have you ever been bored to death?
M&Ms are produced by the Mars Wrigley Confectionery Division of Mars Incorporated. They have colored the lives of many for a great number of years. They were founded in 1947, so that makes it a whopping 77 years. The original candies were filled with milk chocolate, and they did very well for the longest time, yet the company introduced other types of M&Ms along the way, the most popular being the peanut-filled variety. Other flavors you may not have known about include almond, peanut butter, pretzel, and even crunchy.
Lady, for God's sake, I'm just a hard-shelled chocolate candy.
It has been reported that Mars produces an astonishing 400 million M&Ms a day, with U.S. production in New Jersey and Tennessee. So if we take out our old calculators, that comes out to about 2 billion M&Ms made every week. That means if they produce every week year-round, then that's 104 billion candies a year. That's definitely a lot of candy, which sounds like such an understatement after those massive numbers. An employee of the plant would definitely have a lot to boast about at the dinner table after a hard day's work. And more than that, we wonder how many samples they get to bring home.
I'm Nick Dawson, and I'm a Martian.
The origin of the Mike and Ike name.
All right, here's your Mike and Ikes with all the Ikes taken out.
Mike and Ike has come in many flavors over the long years since its inception, and the world is all the more grateful for it. The candy originated in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania in 1940, and was available at first only with their original flavors, lemon, lime, orange, and cherry. But that wouldn't set the tone for where the company would go, ultimately offering a plethora of amazing flavors. The candy's peculiar name and its origins are actually still argued to this day, with a number of possible theories.
So what do I find out, man? What do I find out?
Some believe that the candy was named after the old comic strip Mike and Ike. They both look alike. Some believe that the candies were named after the Mattina brothers, who were little people performers that were extremely popular at the time. They actually played Munchkins in The Wizard of Oz. And finally, some believe that they were named after a vaudeville song by the same exact name. But of course, no one seems to be sure exactly. The company has released many different flavors over the long years, cotton candy and root beer included, but no definitive backstory on the name.
I guess they broke up.
The M&M's candy surface serves a purpose.
What is my purpose?
Pass the butter.
The M&M slogan, "melts in your mouth, not in your hand," actually comes from the company's origins. Essentially, the whole reason that the milk chocolate is covered by a candied coating is so that the chocolate wouldn't melt. This was inspired by a practice used by the military to enable soldiers to carry chocolate on their person in warm climates, the candy shell allowing the chocolate within to remain intact.
Well, it's our job to change that.
Candies and chocolate were actually believed to inspire happiness and battle depression in soldiers during times of unrest, so protecting that candy was definitely a priority. M&M decided to apply the practice when they created these colorful candies we all enjoy to this day. It was genius, as children have always been able to enjoy them on warm days as well as cold.
So that's what you meant by dessert.
Skittles originated in Britain.
Britannia rules the world.
It's true. Skittles were actually made the first time by a company operating out of Great Britain. And they're actually a lot younger than you'd think, especially when compared to a lot of other candies out there. Skittles were invented in 1974, and they didn't migrate to North America until 1979, which makes this particularly popular candy only about 40 years old. It ended up getting consumed more over here than it ever did where it originated, but then again, North America consumes all delicious products at a quicker pace than the rest of the world.
And if there's one thing I've learned about money,
It's that it never runs out.
It is now a part of the candy-producing conglomerate, the Wrigley Company, which is, of course, a division of Mars Incorporated. While no chocolate at all makes itself available in the form of Skittles, they do have some pretty outrageous flavors. Of course, the original red packaging is the most popular, and probably always will be, but there are other flavor combinations such as tropical, sour, wild berry, and even sweet heat, their spicy variety, do well out there. No matter what kind of sweet tooth you have, Skittles has a flavor for you. Salt water taffy.
And I'm a man who enjoys his taffy.
So the Jersey Shore isn't only known for giving us the likes of Snooki, Jay Wow, and Mike the Situation Sorrentino. As it turns out, one of North America's favorite treats originated from the same place. Specifically, it was founded in and originally made in the areas of the Jersey Shore, Atlantic City, and other parts of New Jersey. Extremely popular because of its difficulty to chew, saltwater taffy's smooth and sweet flavor makes it just right. And it isn't at all overpoweringly sweet. It has just the right elements of sweetness thrown in. Its etymology goes way back to the 19th century. The masses have been enjoying this candy for a long time indeed.
It was in all the papers.
The name, however, is quite misleading in that there is no salt water in the recipe. As it turns out, in the later portion of the 19th century, a massive storm hit the area where taffy was produced and sold, specifically an Atlantic City boardwalk. The area was completely flooded. Shortly after, a patron showed up in one of the many boardwalk shops and asked for some candy. The owner of the shop actually joked and said that all that was left after the storm was saltwater taffy. He said this in reference to all of the ocean water that had flooded his shop. Now talk about the joke heard round the world. It transcended time. And still today, people are referencing that comment he made at the frustration from the flood, and the taffy is known now and forever as saltwater taffy.
Like, please just stop. You know, obviously there's history.
Gobstoppers and Laffy Taffy.
You can suck them and suck them and suck them, and they'll never get any smaller.
Authors and writers of fiction sometimes happen to touch onto something that can one day come to fruition. They say that author Jules Verne actually wrote about many items that were not even in existence yet, like remote control devices, certain types of weapons, and the list goes on. Inventions that eventually came to fruition, but only after he'd written about them, and long after that. So was the case for this particular brand of candy. The former pilot turned novelist hailed from Wales. His name was Roald Dahl, and he gave the world some of the most successful novels: Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, The Fantastic Mr. Fox, Matilda, James and the Giant Peach, and of course, Gremlins.
It could change the world.
Like many of Roald Dahl's stories, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory was ultimately turned into a hit film, but the film would have never come to fruition had it not been for the Quaker Oats Company. Interestingly enough, the company actually helped finance the film, but that gesture wasn't at all as selfless as it may have seemed. As it turns out, they helped launch the film all the while planning to launch a candy line at the same time, hoping that the film would provide ample attention for their brand of candy. It was called the Willy Wonka Candy Company, and just as they planned it, it ended up working out really well. As what child didn't want to eat the candy that they saw in the hit film? So we have Roald Dahl to thank for candies such as Nerds, Runts, Gobstoppers, Fun Dip, and Sweet Tarts.
This is called a scumdiddly umptious bar.
Candy corn can last a really long time.
It's not candy, it's not corn.
When you think of Halloween, probably one of the first thoughts you get, after ghosts, goblins, vampires, and zombies,
oh my,
are the many treats that are associated with the holiday. And probably one of the most famous, or rather infamous, of those treats is none other than candy corn. The candy is exceptionally particular in that it actually looks like kernel corn, with the added colors of white and orange, and its taste is tasty enough to be quite memorable. So much so that many get cravings for this candy all year round. But as it turns out, getting this candy in stores year round may be a wee bit of a problem.
What? Halloween in January?
But have no fear, as there is a way to enjoy candy corn at any time of year. Just buy a heck of a lot more of it than you think you'll be consuming over the Halloween season. Will it go bad, you ask? As it turns out, not at all. Apparently, after a bag of candy corn is open, it can last from anywhere between 3 to 6 months. And that's only if you happen to open the bag. If it stays sealed, you're good until the end of the summer, which will bring you safely back to Halloween season, when you'll start seeing this stuff back on those market shelves. Just remember to store it in a cool, dry place and away from direct sunlight. A candy that needs to be kept out of direct sunlight sounds like the perfect candy for Halloween. Like the vampires of old, they do their best in the dark crevices of our pantries, and only there will they survive the bright, sunny days of summer.
Okay, I am at full candy corn right now.
A Twix spread actually exists.
But I tell you, it is preposterous.
Of course, you only have to be willing to travel land and sea if you happen to dwell in North America. That's right, it's only available in the United Kingdom. Sorry, folks, but it's true. The Twix company has actually developed a spread out of this candy, and many have compared it to Nutella.
Do you hear that, Doug? I'm coming to London!
This spread has some caramel and biscuit thrown in. Now imagine that spread across your toast or a warm croissant straight out of the oven. Sounds mouthwatering? That's because it surely is. Just be ready to bite into something super sweet, but for many, that presents no problem at all, as the sweeter, the better. It's unclear as to whether the company has made plans to sell jars of this stuff overseas, but we'd imagine that it would do well. However, similar spreads that were released in the past, like Reese's Peanut Butter Cup spread, actually did quite badly in the North American market, as well as other spreads that didn't quite hit the mark with consumers, which is why there might be a bit of a hold on this one. But if you happen to want a taste, just go over to the UK and bring us back a batch while you're at it. We'll have the croissants warmed and ready.
En français.
Dots gumdrops are gluten-free.
People saying that gluten is the cause of cancer, gluten should be avoided.
There are many people that are allergic or intolerant to gluten, and that means that they have to stay away from products that contain this particular ingredient. The diet industry has jumped on this bandwagon, and the fitness industry as well, and they have concluded that a gluten-free diet is also a great way to shed quite a few of those unwanted pounds. And as beach season approaches rather quickly, many are jumping onto gluten-free diets and other low-carb diets in hopes of looking rather in shape when they hit the beaches of the world.
Never eat dots alone.
The great news in all of this is that they won't have to give up some candy in the process, as Dots gumdrops are actually gluten-free. And they're vegan-friendly to boot. This fruity-flavored variety of candy has been around since 1945, and the company claims that it's the number one best-selling gumdrop brand. They're marketed by Tootsie Roll Industries and have indeed been a top seller, as they claim. From out of their Chicago plant, an astonishing 4 billion dots are made and distributed in a single year. That sure isn't as many as M&Ms can boast about, but it is a lot just the same. So while you're doing those crunches, push-ups, curl-ups, and hours of elliptical training, pop a few of these in your mouth for energy and worry not about the gluten. Besides, you can use a treat after all those sets and reps. You deserve it.
We all make mistakes. Doesn't mean we have less right to a piece of the pie.
The Three Musketeers Bar.
Two of the musketeers are called Athos and Porthos.
The Three Musketeers Bar was introduced way back in 1932 by Mars. It was only the third bar to be offered by the company, the other two being the Mars Bar and the Snickers Bar. But when the Three Musketeers Bar was first seen, it only had a few ingredients thrown into the mix. In fact, three in all, hence the name. The bar contained vanilla, nougat, and strawberry. But as it turned out, strawberry and vanilla were actually very expensive and hard to use during the Second World War, thus the company's decision to drop the other two ingredients. But the name stuck, and after all these years and for many consumers, the nougat was more than enough to satisfy their cravings for the bar.
You've obviously never tried these.
However, after celebrating their 75th anniversary, the company launched other flavors of the bar, with vanilla and strawberry having a festive return, though the first of the new flavors was none other than mint. This did quite well, but still, sales are highest when the old standard flavor is concerned. As they say, nothing beats a classic.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
Stick around, we've got more great videos on our menu. Just tap that screen, it's that easy. And if you're new to our channel, show us some love. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell to join our notification squad.